Good morning to one and all. Welcome to Bridge Course, Siddipet District. This is Geeta Devi, CRT Maths from KGBV Madhupur.
Children, from arithmetic and menstruation, we are learning today. Our topic name is Surface Areas and Volumes, 3D Cone, Learning Outcomes. Recall the 2D shapes, introducing 3D shapes, surface areas and volumes, 3D cone. Children, observe the shapes. What are the shapes? S, triangle, square, rectangle, trapezoid, parallelogram, rhombus, pentagon, hexagon, circle, and oval. Children, here, these all are having length and breadth. So, here, these shapes are having length and breadth only. So, we call for these shapes as 2D shapes. Okay, na? So 2D is nothing but two dimensions. Here two dimensions are length and breadth. Children, observe the shapes. Cube. What is this, children? Yes, it is cube. Next, cuboid, cylinder, sphere, pyramid, cone. Once, see the cuboid. So what is there here? Yes, length, breadth. One new one is there. What is that? Height. So, here how many dimensions are there? As here, three dimensions are there. So, what is that, children? Length, breadth and height. So, here once see the 3D shapes. What is that? Sphere, cube, cuboid, pyramid, cylinder, triangular prism and cone. See, children, here these all shapes are having length, breadth, height. So we call for these three dimension shapes or 3D shapes. Now cone. Cone. A cone has a circular or oval base with an apex, vertex. A cone is a rotated triangle. Based on how the apex is aligned to the center of the base, a right corner or oblique cone is formed. See, children, our ice cream is in the shape of cone only. Next, cone. Observe the picture. What is there, children, here? Yes. Here, slant height, radius, height, base and vertex. So, here, L is equals to slant height of the cone. R is equals to radius of the circular base of the cone. H is equals to height of the cone. So these all are L, R, H. L is nothing but slant height. H is nothing but height of the cone. And R is nothing but radius of the cone. Next, curved surface area of a cone. Calculate the curved surface. We divide it into a circular base and the top slanted part. The area of the slanted part gives you the curved surface area. Area of the circular base. Area of the circular base is, what is the formula, children? Yes, that is pi r square. So, next. Now, that curved surface area, how many parts, children? Yes, that is circle and slanted part. Now, that base is in the shape of circle. So, area of the circle is equals to pi r square, where r is the base radius of the cone. Now, if open the curved top and cut into small pieces, so that each cut portion is a small triangle. How it is there, children? Yes, that are small triangles, whose height is a slant height L of the cone. Now, the area of each triangle, what is the area of triangle formula, children? Yes, it is half into base into height. So, here half into base of each triangle into L. So, area of the curved surface, sum of the areas of the all triangles. So, 1 by 2 into B1 into L plus 1 by 2 into B2 into L plus so on. 1 by 2 into Bn into L. So, here 1 by 2 and L is a common. What is the remaining, children? S here. B1 plus B2 plus B3 so on plus Bn. So these all are curved surfaces. That is why you should write like this. Half into L into curved surfaces. From the figure, we know that the curved surface is equivalent to the perimeter of the base of the cone. So here, circumference of the base of cone is equals to 2 pi r. Because this is the base is like circle. So area of curved surface is 1 by 2 into L into 2 pi r. 2 to get cancelled. What is the remaining children? Pi r l. So that is why what is our formula now? Area of the curved surface is equals to pi r l. Children, see one example. Determine the curved surface area of a cone whose base radius is 7 cm and slant height is 15 cm. What they gave children? Yes, here radius is equals to 7 and slant height L is equals to 15. What is the curved surface area of cone children? Yes, it is pi r L. And the pi value we are taking here 22 by 7. Another value is there, that is 3.14 also. So here we are taking 22 by 7 into 7 into 15. So 7 get cancelled. What is the remaining? Yes, 22 into 15. So 22 into 15, that is 330. So here curved surface area of cone is equals to 330 centimeter square. Children, now total surface area of a cone. The total surface area of a cone is defined as the total area of the cone occupied in a three-dimensional area. It is equal to the sum of the curved surface area and the base of the cone. So the formula to calculate the total surface area of a cone is given by. Children, here two parts are there. Till now we took the same as this. One is circle and one is slant area. So here total surface area, TSA short form, is equals to curved surface area plus area of circular base. So area of circular base, what is the formula? Yes, it is pi r square. Curved surface area is pi r l. So here TSA is equals to pi r is a common, so our formula is pi r into r plus l. Here r is equals to radius of the circular base of the cone and L is equals to slant height of the cone. See one example. Calculate the total surface area of a cone whose diameter is 8 cm and the slant height is 10 cm. So here they give for us diameter. But we want here radius. So radius is equals to half of the diameter. So given that height of the cone is equals to 10 cm. Diameter of the cone is equals to 8 centimeters. R is equals to D by 2. Here D they gave as 8 by 2 is equals to 4. What is our formula children? S. It is pi R into L plus R. So here pi value is 22 by 7 into R value is 4 and R value 4 plus L value is 10. So 4 plus 10 is nothing but 14 and 7 and 14 is there, no? 7 1s and 7 2s. So 22 into 4 into 2. So we do the multiplication, we will get the answer 176. So therefore TSA of a cone is equals to 176 square centimeters. Now volume of a cone. You can think of a cone as a triangle which is being rotated about one of its vertices. Now think of Scanado when we need to calculate the amount of water that can be accommodated in a conical flask. In other words, calculate the capacity of the flask. The capacity of a conical flask is basically equal to the volume of the cone involved. Thus, the volume of a three-dimensional shape is equal to the amount of space occupied by that shape. Let us perform an activity. With one activity, we should do now find out volume of a cone. Take a cylindrical container and conical flask of the same height and the same base radius. Radius will be same, cylinder and conical flask. Add water the conical flask such that it's filled to the brim. Start adding this water to the cylindrical container you took. You will notice it doesn't fill
of the container fully. Try repeating this experiment for once more. You will still observe some vacant space in the container. Repeat this experiment once again. You will need you will notice this time the cylindrical container is completely filled. How many times we fill, children? Yes, we fill 3 times. Thus the volume of a cone is equals to 1/3 of the volume of a cylinder having the same base radius and height. Here height will be same and radius and base. So how many times we fill, children? How many times? Yes, here 3 times we fill. Now let us derive its formula. Suppose a cone has circular base with radius r and height h. The volume of this cone will be equal to the 1/3 of the product of the area of the base and its height. Therefore v is equals to, here we are volume is nothing but v, 1/3 into area of circular base into height of the cone. Here area of the circular base is nothing but what, children? Yes, it is pi r square. And height of the cone, what is that? H. So what is the formula now? V is equals to 1/3 into pi r square into h. Here v is the volume and r is the radius and h is the height. Children, volume of a cylinder is pi r square h. So in cylinder how many times we fill the water? Yes, 3 times. So that is, remember that 3 times, that is 1/3. So now volume of a cone is 1/3 pi r square h. So let us see one example. Calculate the volume if r is equals to 2 centimeters and h is equals to 5 centimeters. Given that r is equals to 2 centimeters and h is equals to 5 centimeters. The volume of a cone, what is the, children? Yes, it is 1/3 pi r square h. Here I wrote cubic units because this is volume. Volume is nothing but length, breadth and height. So v is equals to 1/3 into, here till now I said no, pi value 22/7 we are able to take, and 3.14. So here I took 3.14. So r how many times, children? Yes, here 2 times. So that is 2 square into pi. So 1/3 into 3.14, 2 square is nothing but 4 and same as it is 5. Now 4 5s are 20. So v is equals to 1/3 into 3.14 into 20. We will do the simplification and we will get the value 20.93 centimeter cube. Therefore the volume of a cone is equals to 20.93 cubic units. Children, this is your homework time. First question. The slant height of a cone is 20 centimeters. The diameter of the base is 15 centimeters. Find the curved surface area of cone. Second question. If the height of a given cone is 7 centimeters and the diameter of the circular base is 6 centimeters, then find its value. Third question. A joker's cap in the form of right circular cone whose base radius is 7 centimeters and height is 24 centimeters. Find the area of the sheet required to make 10 such caps. Thank you. Thanks for giving this opportunity to me, sir.